What is an annular tear? I'm Dr. John Shim, and today I'd like to discuss a very intimidating sounding term. Many of my patients have had episodes of neck or back pain, and during the course of evaluation, a test called an MRI was obtained. Oftentimes, the studies identify things like bulges and herniations. If you have watched my prior videos, you'll know that it's a very common finding on MRIs, and whether you do or do not have pain, you can find them. What scares many, however, is the term annular tear. It sounds very painful. It sounds like a big problem. The truth is, it may or may not be an issue. Let me explain. To summarize basic disc anatomy, there are two main components. There's the softer inside of the disc called the nucleus. It's full of water. It gives the shock absorbing properties of the disc. There's also the outer component of the disc called the annulus. It's a very tough, ropey structure that holds the nucleus into the center of the disc. If you have a disc herniation, by definition, the nucleus material has to come out of its normal central location and through the annulus or a break through the top or bottom of the disc bone interface called the end plate. This break in the annulus can be called a annular fissure, or the more scary term is annular tear. The medical community is still trying to identify these annular tears through various diagnostic studies. The best way to identify the breaks is to inject a disc with dye material, and then, because of the break, the dye material can be seen escaping the disc on cross-sectional CAT scan. That is the definitive diagnosis of a break in the annulus. To do this test, it can be very painful, it is invasive, and unfortunately, the latest information indicates that doing the discogram procedure itself can potentially lead to accelerated disc degeneration. Yes, this procedure is called a discogram, and it does remain controversial, and there are concerns that the procedure itself will cause future degeneration. MRI studies are less invasive. In the 1990s, as MRI studies were becoming more commonly used, findings towards the edge of the annulus called high-intensity zones were initially thought to indicate new breaks in the annulus or even indicate pain coming from the annulus. This too became a very controversial issue. In the 1990s, many people had surgery for these so-called high-intensity zones. Unfortunately, the results were not as predictable as thought. Now there have been further studies indicating these high-intensity zones may not, in fact, indicate an annular tear. Long-term studies of these high-intensity zone findings found that they may never actually go away. So there's really no way to know if these findings demonstrate a new or an acute problem. From a diagnostic standpoint, in my opinion, there are still too many unknowns and associated risks to try to identify an annular tear. From my perspective as a spinal specialist, because a fissure in the annulus is necessary to create a disc, it is my opinion that in general, if you have a disc herniation, you will likely have an associated annular fissure or tear. The other possibility, of course, is a break of the end plate that allows the central nucleus to come out of its normal position. The term tear emotionally associates with some sort of traumatic event. What we know of disc herniations is that they can occur with what sounds like very trivial motions. Sneezing, coughing, bearing down while in the bathroom, twisting in bed, reaching for an object. These are very trivial appearing motions, but are associated with herniated discs. While it is true that activities such as a significant fall, a direct blow, or a car accident can cause herniated discs, everyday activities of life also are just as likely to cause these herniations. The more the medical community learns, the more we realize that genetics is playing a significant role in development of disc abnormalities. In my opinion, the term annular tear on MRI study may or may not have any significant bearing on your current condition. The term annular tear on MRI is typically associated with the so-called high-intensity zone, which we now know may or may not be symptomatic. In other words, may or may not be the source of your pain. While the term annular tear sounds scary, it may not be the source of any pain. As I stated, this high intensity finding was used as an indication for surgical management in the past. As of 2019, the finding by itself is no longer an indication for need for operation. The finding by itself does not make you a quote candidate for surgery. If you have an annular tear on your test results, do not be scared. Get a comprehensive second opinion by a spinal specialist. This is Dr. John Shim discussing annular tears. I hope this gives you some comfort when you read that scary testing result. If you find this information helpful, please sign up for our video channel. We welcome suggestions for further videos. Thank you.